Lights CR. We are live here from the K. Bailey Hutchison Arena in Dallas, Texas. That's back right. With another C3W stream.
The home of wrestling.
The home of wrestling, Dallas, Texas.
The home of wrestling.
Now, I have to say, it is great to have you in the booth. One of these, usually Ricky's here joining me. But Ricky is currently busy trying to get himself in on the LCQ train, get himself registered.
That's right.
His registration tomorrow. But here at Crew3W, we got a big problem. The Phyrexians are trying to invade, and we are here to stop them. So why don't you say we head on over to the arena and check out our first match tonight?
Let's do it.
Also, chat, we're kind of bouncing around the audio, so let us know how we sound versus the match
pretty quick. So it's so loud in the arena. Thousands of fans here. It's difficult to hear. So let us know how we're doing.
Our first match here. We have a difficulty, but the Silver Tokens are round one defenders of C3W.
Round one every time. That's right.
And of course, look, we started from the side. We have now given them action. And of course, Chris did not allow to have any music, but
they're only Silver Tokens. That's right.
The blow is on the
that's right.
They don't even have making his way to the ring.
Move.
From
move.
From
you feel that?
I felt that.
Being in at 130 pounds,
yeah. Great
of Trash Man.
Yeah. Oh, man. Here they go. Several
times,
hyping themselves up as they
need
to do.
Now, look, going into this, I think this match, I'm pretty easily matched up against the competitors here. Now, one thing Sergio does have over his opponent is that the platform cannot block.
Okay, cannot block any attack.
Cannot block, but okay. It does, of course, have toxic one.
Right. That the not being able to block seems like a significant disadvantage in real life.
In a fight, yes.
In a fight, it seems like, just based on my years of fighting experience, that blocking is usually a good strategy.
Yeah.
At least some number of the time.
Here we go. The challenger, our first look at the Frexy Invaders, the Mike Coke.
The Mike. Here we go.
He looks mighty hungry.
Look at that Twitter handle. Yeah, looks starving. Looks ready to potentially munch on some Servo token.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, hopefully, we are now giving them extra music and paying them that Servo token will not steal any of the resources, as he likes to do.
We're paying them now?
Don't tell the other wrestlers
that. We're paying the Servo tokens?
Don't tell the other wrestlers that.
What are we doing? We'll go over that later in this month's budget meetings.
All right, here we go. We are ready for round one action here.
Let's check it out. Oh, as you said, the Might Token, not blocking at all.
Not blocking. Servo Token off very early aggression on this matchup. Taking it right to the Might Token.
Oh, reversal, though. They can do a reversal. Cannot block, but reversals are an option. Oh, there's the Pia's Revenge right there. I saw
right,
that one.
Yeah.
Oh, a solid stop.
My token says, I don't need to block, I'm on the attack.
That's exactly right. The best defense
is a good offense.
Is a good offense. Thank you, ZR. You knew right what I was going for. The fans love the Might Token. They're excited for it. Oh, we were in the midst of an animation for a DDT.
That combo.
And then all of a sudden we warped through a punch. You know, those Phyrexians, they have the ability to warp time.
That's correct.
A small amount. Oh, Servo trying to get to the ropes.
Servo going to the corner.
Makes it to the
Mike
ropes.
Token, though, setting something up here.
It's not a block, whatever it is. They're not setting up a block.
Oh! Ooh.
The super spin DDT.
Tilt-a-whirl DDT there.
That's what I said. Going for a quick pin, kicks
early
out.
Early pin, Servo kicks out of one. You were correct there, CR.
Yeah.
Mike Token revving up the crowd not having any
of
it.
Yeah, goes for an attack there, totally whiffs. The Servo Token with the comebacks. Oh, this looks painful. Oh, that doesn't look good. Oh, that doesn't look good. Whatever that is, it didn't look good.
And the other thing, that's metal on bare flesh.
Yeah.
That has got to not feel great.
Oh, the neck crank. I had my neck recently cranked.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, you did not sign up for that.
No, I did not sign up for it.
Remember, all of these competitors, they do sign waivers that we are not liable.
That's right.
Anything that happens.
And that usually they will not be paid. Usually we slide
look,
that in
I'm
the contract.
Sorry, look, I didn't think 25 cents would be a big deal.
Yeah, for a Servo token, that's a year's allowance. Gets the pin, gets the kick out. We're back at it. Oh, an ear clap looks like there to me.
Of course, this match and all of our matches tonight being officiated. Oh, neckbreaker.
Oh,
there we go.
Oh, that's brutal for a little token.
That's right.
Little token.
Of course, as we were saying, this match being officiated by longtime Crew 3 official, Wavering Mike.
Yes. Yeah, Wavering Mike. Thank you, Wavering Mike, for your unwavering dedication.
That's right.
He may waver. His dedication does not.
That's
exactly
right.
Right.
He is the only person to be classically paid in this.
Exactly right. Exactly right. Oh, some crucial smacks here.
There we go. Oh, servo token revving up here.
Feeling himself, if you can. You can do that for a servo token.
Servo says, come on, give me some more.
Yep.
Setting him up for something
angling,
big here.
We're angling something here. We're going to go to the top rope.
Yeah, keep him down.
Okay, we want to hold
servo
hands.
Servo token smartly dragging his opponent away from the ropes.
Yep.
Leg up on the ropes, though. Leg up on the ropes.
Oh, leg is on the ropes. You got to let them go when they get to the ropes. That's how wrestling works.
Servo token wondering how this is getting away from him.
Yeah, he thought this was going to be an easy matchup. Let's see. Oh, this looks like it's going to hurt.
Oh, Mike fighting out.
With the low blow.
Whatever servo token was setting up, the Mike is breaking out of.
That's exactly right. Oh, okay. There we go. Oh, a double reversal.
Oh!
Drop kick. But servo token right back up. Did you see that recovery?
Look, when you have an exoskeleton, you don't need to worry about your spine.
Yeah, fair enough. Fair enough. Going for the spine, a poor strategy against the servo token. But servo again, intelligently dragging
the middle of the ring.
It looks like Mike Token might have pooped himself.
That's right.
Just like Ray Allen in the finals of the NBA Championships in 2007.
Oh.
Servo Token.
This is my ring. But we're going to finish this match in the ring. Get the Mike Token up. Possibly throwing him back in the ring here. Or not.
Oh. Where are you taking him?
Servo Token establishing dominance. Taking the Mike Token all the way. Oh.
You know, servo tokens usually have arranged marriage, and my understanding is that's how it starts.
That's
you
right.
pick up the other one, and you just walk off with
that's
it.
That's right,
nobody
yeah.
can say anything. So.
And then two servers show up later on.
Exactly right. Nobody knows how the servo tokens multiply.
This might have backfired on servo token. You're just taking quite the beating on the outside.
This is a count of Wavering Mike looks like Wavering. They're about to 8. Oh! A suplex, but they're at 9. What happens here?
Oh, it's 7.
I can't count. Texas public education. Do not learn yet. Servo tokens can count. CRs cannot. I don't know what that move was called. CR, you have any idea what that one right there was?
My token here loves that taunt. He's showing the mouth. He's saying, this is where you're going.
Yep. Double clothesline. Back-to-back clotheslines. Oh, servo
token.
Oh, wow.
Whoa. Again. Oh, servo token. Trying to go for something here. Woo!
The triple close.
My token here showing peak athleticism here.
Peak, yeah, this is a beating. You can tell that my token is getting instructions from El Shorn.
Yeah.
On the inside of that helmet.
El Shorn, who will of course be our final match evening going up against Elspeth.
Of course. Everybody's excited for that one.
From the top rope, but misses.
But just a total
just
whiff.
Barely misses.
Don't send a Mike token to do a servo token's job. That's what I always say.
Here we go.
What is this here? Oh,
follow away suplex.
Hopefully the exoskeleton protects the servo token in such an instance.
Woo! That's going to be bad for the face.
That's not going to be good. Servo tokens have
generally
brittle
faces. He might have cracked the lens there.
Might have cracked the lens, yep. And that's
Mike
the pair cost that we don't cover.
That's
that
right.
is not covered
we
by
We don't
C3
have vision.
W. Yeah, we do not have insurance. That's covered in the waiver, so.
These are contract employees.
Contract employees, too. And the kick out by Servo on 3. Excellent job. Mike Token can't believe it. Mike Token in absolute disgust. Cannot understand how Servo Token
we're not able to block.
We're doing the Kobe. Did you see the Kobe impersonation?
Woo!
Kobe is so famous, they know about him in Phyrexia. That's
right.
How great of a basketball player that man was.
Mike Token here, it looks like the all-out aggression mentality here. Might have sealed the day.
It might be paying off.
Servo Token currently in a hold right
How
now.
How much can, more of this can Servo
can
Token
Can he break
take?
Out?
My Servo Token can't take this much.
Mike Token cleverly targeting that visual screen that he
yes,
tapped earlier.
Of course. Yeah, yeah. The visuals are the most important part of the Servo Token.
You know what's the most impressive part of the Mike look? obviously, Mike took a lot of muscle, right?
Yep.
But the amount of jaw strength to keep his mouth open this entire time.
That's a lot of jaw strength. My dentist frequently gets mad at me for not keeping my, you know, they've got to put the thing in there
Open, you know? Ooh, okay. Ooh. I think Mike took a busted open
think,
there.
I think there is an indication of some blood on the screen there. Or oil in the Mike took right.
Oh, kicked out of two.
Wavering Mike a little slow on that.
Servo saying, what are you talking about, ref? That was three.
Yeah, I agree with Servo Token here. Wavering Mike, you know, we do pay him in whiskey to start the show, so maybe a little.
Oh, whoa.
Wavering Mike, are you going to stand for that?
Wavering Mike, come on.
Yeah.
Are you going to allow that?
Uh-oh, Wavering Mike dazed in that move right there.
He's so shocked.
Oh, he's going for another quick pin.
Two.
Oh.
Hold on a second.
Did see that.
He counted that out before serving the Mike token.
Yeah, exactly right. He lifted it up before.
He might need a new official.
We might, might need Wavering Mike's cousin.
Is Wavering Mike a sleeper agent?
Yeah, right. We didn't ask that before we signed him. We maybe should have put that in the contract. Servo token.
You legally have to tell us if you're sleeper.
I think that's fair. I think in American law.
Servo token rallying here. All right.
The flying clothesline. A sick move.
Here we go.
Oh, knee to the back. That can't be good.
The crowd's loving this. Talk about a good curtain opener. Mike Token getting out of the face hole here. Servo once again saying, Mike Token just can't.
Mike Token can't deal with it anymore. He's fixing to leave. He's fixing to uninvade.
Yeah. Pack it up. Get the rum breaker. Go home.
Exactly right. Get the rum breaker. Go home.
Woo! Slap right across the face
Mike
there.
Mike Token fight back. Oh! Again, going for that visual visor, right? Targeting the ocular sensors of the Servo Token.
He's seen the weakness. He's going to target.
He's seen it. He's used his observation hockey.
Right.
To see through.
He wants him again. We're going for this. Oh, wait. He connects this time.
First time total whiff. Second time gets the connects.
Is that enough to put it away here? Oh! We're set up. Oh! Once again, slamming right on that optical sensor.
Is that really, that was a reverse spine buster? What is that right there?
That's the Phyrexian special.
The Phyrexian special.
Servo Token, though.
That looked like
out.
A freak out to me, but Servo Token not laying down, not taking the slight.
My Token wants it up again.
Cueing it up. What's going on here?
Oh! Going for the back.
Going for the back again. That's the prime strategy.
Two.
Three.
There
it
is.
It.
Mike Token wins over Servo Token.
Yep. Phyrexian invasion. Starting off with a dub for you. You'll have to run it. It's okay. You'll have to run. It's all right. She's running. They're already afraid of the Phyrexian invasion.
Right.
They're running away behind us. But here at C3W, we are not a fear. Okay.
We are here.
We're going to be bringing you this action
as
all
it
day.
Happens. We are truly dedicated.
That's exactly right. Here's a quick replay of that pin.
Servo.
Oh, he almost did.
Nearly.
Right.
I mean, if you go back and look at that, Mike definitely had, thank you for the subscription hangings.
The rules committee will review it.
That's right.
The Matt Luck gavel will be used.
Here is your winner, Ron.
The fans love us. We're already getting support from
right,
the crowd.
That's right.
Thank you so much, Hankston. I'll tell you what an amazing contribution. Thank you so much. What are we throwing over to
right.
now?
All right, we're getting back to us while we queue up our next match here. Now, I mean,
people CR, are going to tell
CR,
me how you're feeling.
CR, what is going through your head right now after witnessing that match?
What's going through my head right
now?
Yeah. You know, it's concerning. We came here to fight off Phyrexians. That's already not a good sign. Yeah.
So, of course, we're over the next match here, which is going to be our women's 3-on-3 elimination tag match between Kaya, the Wanderer, Liliana, versus Tamio, Nahiri, and Vraska.
Yep. Thank you again to all our supporters in the crowd tonight. This is real exciting. We worked for approximately 45 minutes to bring
That's
you
right.
all this action. It's
we
a
found
lot of work.
People in the crowd,
yep.
threw them in costumes.
That's right. It's a very small
right,
amount of effort
go.
To bring you this.
Here's
show.
Our next match.
We appreciate it.
Yeah, ahead of this matchup, so we have our first set of Phyrexian Planeswalkers,
yep.
of course, against our Fearless Lady Planeswalkers.
That's right.
Now, notably, Nahiri thought she could get through security with sword arms.
Right.
Which we did confiscate.
Right, yeah, we did not allow Nahiri to come in with the giant sword arms. That yes. felt like a distinct advantage.
Yes.
Not only in doing the Mr. Roboto,
yeah.
but also for destroying your opponents
yes.
With metalized sword arms. So. It turns out Nahiri just has regular arms underneath those.
Yeah, surprise, surprise.
Yeah, just like Captain Hook style, grabbing onto it. So not a problem, really, to take those away. Make this a fair fight.
All right, here we go, down to the ring.
We're vibing, you, of course. You know,
back
you know,
here
CR,
in the Crew3 Arena, live from Dallas, Texas.
Waiting on these new intros. A lot of people in the crowd dressed up tonight.
Right.
Dressed up as their favorite planeswalkers from many different franchises. Exciting to see.
Yeah.
What matchup do you think you're most excited for tonight?
I mean, looking at the card here, I mean, obviously, I'm not just saying this because it's us, but Crew3 versus Torb Rankle for their careers
yeah.
is going to be a barnstormer.
Look, I see your analysis on that matchup. Brilliant.
We briefly brought in Torb Rankle to try him out here, and it caused nothing but trouble for us backstage.
Yeah.
So we said, you know what? You guys, one last match.
One last one. Otherwise, we're bringing the turf.
Right.
Get out of here. Taya, entering Ghost form right now.
Right.
Look at that
tear
face.
Building up that ghostly energy in her hand.
Yep. See him. Not somebody that I would want to be messing with first.
Right. Now, we told her she cannot expect the Triple A Fury
place.
We said no ghost knives.
Yeah, that's right.
You can still use ghost towers,
yeah.
but no ghost knives.
No ghost knives. That's right. No Terminator stuff.
That's right.
Right. That's all copyright. You can't do that. Those, of course, Blue Jeans there, sent to us by Nate's
right. Blue Jeans, baby, LA lady.
That's right.
The Nate's mom's got you all, your denim.
All your denim. Oh, a little meditation before you get ready.
Right.
Smart move, I think.
Treason bar, retreat, down dog.
Yep, exactly right. As you know, most wrestlers beat themselves in the ring.
Right.
So staying focused is really important.
The floor is shaking again.
The floor is shaking again. It is pretty hype here. A lot of action going on in the background.
Lot, yeah, that's right.
Some people are fighting in the crowd. Need to ask them to
leave it for the ring only.
Yeah.
I am glad we were able to lock down the Wanderer through this
meeting.
Obviously, you know, she's on multiple contracts. She's got her.
That's exactly right. Very difficult to do.
We have been assured she will not face down the match.
Exactly right. Contractually obligated.
That's right.
Yeah. Even though we're not paying anything. It's in the contract.
Yeah. It's in the service.
That's exactly right.
You have to pay them for you to reason.
That's exactly right. Yeah. Or you can reason. That's right.
And up this lineup, who on each team do you think are the biggest?
That's a great question. You know, if they enter the ring here, you've got to look at the competitive advantage of the ring, and then totally forget about those and flip the coin.
Okay? Yeah.
You just got to use a random method to determine the winner for the result. Everybody knows that's how you do it at the gathering. So I'm just going to say the Wanderer and the Nahiri. Those
Wanderer
and
Nahiri.
Those are right.
Just
based on a totally okay. random method that I've used to pick them.
Based on play draw.
Based on play draw, exactly right. Everybody knows play draw, real important.
It's the most important thing.
Most important thing.
Here she comes.
Here's a dope entrance right here.
The necromancer herself, Liliana, former C3W Women's Champion.
By the way. Such an unfortunate loss.
Of course, this time apparently held by Ellen Shore.
Making her way to the ring.
Right.
From the other side of darkness, the Necromancer.
Someone said we stole the Undertaker, I say.
Someone said
who's that?
Who is that? That's right. And then I would say, here's $20. Screw off.
That's right.
Leave us alone. What a creepy entrance, though. You know?
Yeah.
Truly horrifying. But the people in the crowd really hyped for it.
Hey, did we get Transformers from the Pyro?
Yes.
Okay, good.
All pyrotechnics are approved by the Texas State Pyrotechnics Agency of Texas Licensing and Approval Court.
Okay. Did the servo set them up?
Yes.
Okay.
Servo set. We couldn't pay anybody else to do it. So servo tokens, that's who we've got to run our office here.
Right.
Who approved the budget for that smoke machine? That's what I want to know. It looks like a lot of smoke. That's all I'm saying.
Well, all I'm saying is, you guys give me the company car for a weekend.
Right. That was a big mistake, obviously.
And Halloween Central was open.
It was open. Strange this time of year, but it was there.
Yeah, they might be
hurt. I think it's a good time now to talk about who we hope to be our sponsor coming up soon. Of course, the Olive Garden.
When you're here, you're a family.
That's exactly what a family attempting to be restored by the Corexians invasion. Right. But I don't know if you know this, Corexians cannot invade an Olive Garden. It's not its own plane.
It's safer ground.
It's safer to be at an Olive Garden,
right,
statistically speaking, than anybody else. If you need any weapons, you can just throw a chicken farm on them.
For 0% off at your next meal, Olive
exactly
Garden.
Right.
Tell us Crew3 sent you.
That's right. Tell your server that you're with Crew3 and just see what they do. You know, it can't hurt you, right? Ask them for 10% off. Turn
right
your mindset
the
into a
price.
Right.
See what happens.
There's a heart for the shot you don't take.
That's
Michael
exactly
Scott Wayne Gretzky.
Michael Scott Wayne Gretzky. That's exactly right. Okay. A slow and dreary entrance.
Cameo, of course, the first completed planeswalker.
Yes. One of the first.
So getting her out of the way early, I think, is key.
Yeah.
For the Lady Flamethrower.
Cameo has some of the most experience of any of the Corexians.
Right.
Important to consider that in your strategy.
Yeah.
Whose intro do you think you like the best here?
I think it's good.
Yeah.
I'm just wanting to vibe with the Olive playing the there. Actually, it's really magic.
I like the Liliana one.
Yeah, the Liliana one's good. I mean, I think my favorite match is actually the next match.
Okay.
With Thor Brankle.
With Thor Brankle. Fair. Please, as it mentions in the background here, please do not try magical wrestling at home. Okay? This is all very high-level
right
stuff. A lot of magic.
These are trained professionals. They all paid their mana.
A lot of magic going along. A lot of
right
jutsus.
That's right. Chris is out there giving them jute chops.
Jimmy Chops. The Jimmy Sue's, you know what I'm
yeah
talking about.
I know what you're doing.
You know what I'm talking about.
That's right.
Well, this is metal AF right here.
Right.
Why did we let that bear on fire?
Oh,
so
there it is. It's a wolf.
It's a wolf, okay.
That's why we're on fire.
What's a wolf do?
Nobody, everyone always asks what the wolf do. Someone asks,
how's
the wolf doing?
Exactly right.
They're going to give herself sword tattoos on her arm.
Right.
In protest of taking away her sword arm.
Yeah. A lot of buckles reminiscent. I'm not sure wearing a corset is the best strategy for your wrestling debut.
Well, it's extra protection, right?
I
don't layer.
I would figure maybe it holds all the Phyrexian stuff on the inside.
Maybe, yeah. You don't know what's under the room.
We don't know what's under there. And I'm a little afraid to look, to be honest with you.
I
think we'll
keep
that under wraps. Yeah. Keep that under wraps right there. Whatever's going on with that. Now, do we need to start hedging our bets in case the Corexians do win?
I, for one, welcome our new Corexian overlord.
Yeah, should we start sucking up a little bit in case we do get successfully evaded? This may next time be called C3W.
Yeah. Well, it'd be C Infinite W, right?
C Infinite W. We're all one.
Yeah,
that's exactly
right.
Right, yeah. Not to be confused with all four ones. We do not own the copyright.
Rast here with the Razor sponsorship.
The Razor sponsorship, exactly right. how did Brass get so popular? They know Jace, right? You know? When you know Jace.
If you find some treasure, you go a long way.
The sponsorship possibilities are easy, but that's clear to say.
I gotta get to the higher reason.
That's exactly right. Wait for these intros to finish up here so we can all six of these competitors in the ring.
The game always comes down to the customization options that are available.
Right.
Like, I can use Fader legs and the, like, Medusa hair here.
Right.
But if the hair piece is too long, you can't use, like, a t-shirt.
Yeah, yeah. It clips, you know?
Yeah.
Let's get the cards in chat for the Lady Flame Buffers here. You're ready to tear up the ring. And again, please do not try this at home.
It's our trained professors after all.
My hero.
I made a Randy Orton. She's the Viper, so she's Randy Orton.
Oh, amazing.
Watch out for some VKOs.
Watch out for some VKOs.
Candy, I'll take it right to Brasky at the opening bout. So clearly, Brasky's on the play this match.
I believe that's Kaya right there.
Stop the face.
That was the old dick force there.
Sure to see that in a woman's match.
Unusual, but it works. You can't argue with it. Oh, a boot to the stomach there.
That looked personal.
It did look personal. Oh, good reversal.
Okay, all right. Kaya breaking out here. Now, again, this is an elimination tag match. Just like we'll see with the men's match later on this evening.
Okay.
So,
double reversals here.
A pinfall here does not make the win.
Oh!
Just eliminate everyone on the roster, the opposing team.
Kaya with a variation of the angle slam.
Wander tagging in here.
Now any non-combat damage, the Wanderer is immune to. So we should not see the Wanderer getting hit by any sprays by the outside assistance there. Only it's a one-on-one match right here. Now that being said, sometimes the Wanderer does bring in.
He tells us to help out.
Does bring in the soldiers. Right. And those soldiers, they're vigilant. They're always looking out.
Right.
A tag in here. Who's the
Nahiri right coming there? In.
That's the Nahiri coming in right there.
Okay.
Oh, that's not the corner you want to be in.
No, you definitely don't want to be thrown in the middle of your opponent's corner.
Wander not caring.
Drag her away to save her space here.
Oh, obviously, you know, if you do any kind of holds, your opponent grabs the ropes there, they get out.
Right.
Free. You want to drag her from the middle anytime you can.
Wander going for the calf crusher here. Ooh. Right to the...
Oh,
here he breaks out. Okay.
Oh! Powerful.
Nahiri working the arm near the Emperor.
I don't know what that move was. It didn't exactly seem regulation, to be honest with you. Oh, getting clotheslined into the turnbuckle.
Dragged on the Emperor there.
Oh, the crowd's loving the taunts.
Crowd is here for it. All right, go to the court. Oh, over the top rope.
Over the top rope.
Onto the outside. Nahiri knows she has to get the Wanderer back in the ring here for elimination.
Now
we've got
to give her a little punishment out first. There's a smack of rules here. First popularized by, I believe, Wayne the Rock Johnson. Oh, a good...
I think Nahiri does have the Rock to use.
A good trip. Yeah.
That was the joke, right?
Yeah. Because Nahiri is scissors.
Yes.
Okay, gotcha. I get it. A little rock, paper, scissors joke there for the crowd. Okay.
All right, throwing her back. Wander actually throwing her back in. Wander right. Able to kind of reverse the beatdown.
Just like a sommelier wanting to go clockwise around their opponent. You can't go back, okay?
Liana in the match.
Coming in fierce.
Yeah, hold on, though.
Thankfully, Waver and Mike covering all the action, making sure all these moves are legal.
Well, I'll move us up top. I'll move us here back down so we can keep an eye on the tags.
I back up here and shake there for a while. Oh, uppercut. Uppercut straight to Nebraska. Liliana came ready to play. Liliana ready to defend the home plane. Ooh, a little smack on the push there. Grabbing Nebraska by the hair. Perfectly legal in C3W.
That is correct. Hair pulling encouraged.
Oh! Variant on the spine buster there. Ooh. Oh, straight to the back of the head, Coach Raskin.
Raskin here, they're letting down some early dominance against Liliana. Taking her back to their corner.
Smart. Obviously, that.
You want to isolate your opponent, keep them separate from the rest of their team,
right.
Take the tagging in and toss them.
That's exactly right.
Liliana, though, not going to take it, break it out of here. Putting Liliana in the corner now.
We're looking for Liliana's signature move to come out at some point.
The tombstone pile driver.
Bring Liliana to the center of the ring. Grab the leg.
Might be dead.
Thinking better of it, tagging the Heary in for clearly some kind of double move here.
Mike, come on, get the Grask out of here.
Grask exiting the ring. But a true competitor. Ooh, the neck cranks. Ooh, there we go. Drop down headbutt there.
There we go. Setting her up. Oh, suplex.
German suplex, wow. Germany, not even from Liliana's home plane. But these wrestling moves, they transcend planes.
Kinda though. The ghost asked herself, what was to finish things off?
Ooh. Oh, counterpunch.
Kaya taking it, though.
Shaking that arm out.
Ooh, drops her. Oh, a little bit of time here. Here we go. The most much fun move in sports entertainment. People's elbow.
Everybody's elbow. Yes. Okay, it's everybody's elbow in sports entertainment.
Kaya kicked it out of the everybody's elbow.
The everybody's elbow. There we go. Oh,
all the girls. Both tagging and wandering. Woo! Brask and Tanya definitely trying to get in here.
Yep. Oh, Brask
gets
the tag.
Brask gets the
kinda
tag.
Kind of confusing on who's legal here. They eventually pick it up.
Wander, can she put some away here?
Attempts a reversal, then goes to the overarm throw.
18 minutes in, and no one has been eliminated this match yet.
No elimination so far. What are the ways in which you could be eliminated in this match?
These matches are by pinfall or submission.
Pinfall or submission. No one can throw back. That's right, we are.
This is not the fear of the computer rumble.
Oh, ooh, cool. Benji kick right there. Woo! Wanderer, Benji kicking her gizzards there.
And run around like an airplane.
That's right.
Hey, you got the leg.
Went for the suplex.
Ooh, going for the wanderer lock. Wanderer lock.
Right. Going for the cross plane.
Getting her away from the rope.
Smart. Dragging her back to the center.
Go up that arm.
Ooh. Oh.
Go.
The arm breaker. Brassic, unfortunately, throw those back to the easy one.
Ooh, going for the emperor lock again.
Okay. To hear, you're going to have something to say about it.
Nebraska tap here. Nebraska breaks out, okay.
Looks off, no problem. Oh, Nebraska reaching the ropes. We got a smart thing here.
There's a tap
we
here.
We grabbed the arm that was closest to the ropes.
That's right. Nebraska working her way out again. Whoa!
That was something out of Spy Kids right there. Wander
kicks right to the abdomen there.
Oh, well, Wander, Texas Ranger action.
Right.
Didn't know the Wander is a big fan of the state of Texas. Immediate kick out. What was Liliana doing in the ring? I didn't catch that.
I think she was trying to break up potential interference there.
Oh, Wander's looking at the top turn.
Setting her up.
Oh.
EDT.
Kai, you can clearly see, not happy about that. Really
not at all.
In there and help the teammate.
Not at all.
Oh, punch to the back there.
Oh! DKO!
The DKO. We were waiting for it. You called it out. There it is. I don't see this going well.
Is
it
going
up? Kaya.
Kaya break up pinfall.
Breaking it up.
Oh! Ooh, Cameo here.
Cameo's not going to take that lightly. He's not liking the interference.
Yeah, of course, all these are impromptu teams. Obviously, the Planeswalkers are very impromptu.
Right.
The Phyrexians here on a grind meld.
Yes.
I have to say, I think I've seen better teamwork out of the Lady Planeswalkers than I have the Phyrexians.
That seems to be true. Oh, elbow. Oh, overhand. Overheads, unblockable.
Kaya phased into the ropes there.
Oh, of course. Said they could not phase hands.
I don't know what happened there.
They phased out too quick.
Right.
Did not phase back in at the right time.
Kaya, though, really can't get to him here.
Wow. Reversal into the
dip. Mid-air reversal.
In all my years, I have never seen that reversal right there.
That was very impressive.
That was
impressive. Picking her up.
With the foot. Look at this.
Go for the dock out.
Oh, another. All these ladies.
The regicide kick.
Walker, Texas Ranger. Wavering Mike distracted by the...
Is the regicide enough to put away the hearing here? Kaya picks the first pinfall.
There you go.
Ever set up Braska there on the bottom of the screen.
Yep. Grand interference to stop the initial pin.
Tag into Wanderer. Stereo.
Wow. We call that the Wanderer Von Dudley.
Woo. Got it locked in again, working it up once again.
We got the arm bar going.
Back to
taps! Taps! It's a 3-on-1 match here. Wow. The dominant arm
down.
Is Planeswalker. So
just Tomio.
Oh, getting thrown back with the matchup. Can't run away from this.
All right, it would be... The odds are stacked against Tomio, but... Rexy has proven to be pretty resilient.
Yeah, would be smart to probably retire here. And come back for another round. Regroup.
No shame. Water blows low here. Once again, Mike letting it happen.
Mike
knows health's on the line here. He's not going to let something
right.
Like that.
Let him play, Mike. You know,
right.
Let him play.
Right.
Parents are out there saying, let him play. We're letting him play. Oh, came to close reversal. Gets the
overarm.
Wander wavering backwards there, taking out a page out of the wavering Mike book. Liliana planted something.
No.
Oh, goes for the punch, gets countered. Okay, Cameo taunting.
Top. No, nothing. Just going for a taunt there. Okay, interesting.
Oh,
take it to the outside.
Doing,
I think, as much damage to herself as she did Liliana.
That's right, but at this point, you can commentate the action possibly from the Planeswalker.
Is that enough, do you think?
I don't think so. I don't think so, but you never know. Oh, repeated elbows to the face. Oh, Cam, if I'm going down, I'm taking you out with me. That chain veil's coming home with me.
That's right, you're in the ring.
Grabbing
the
hair.
Oh, no. Oh! Across the throat.
Quick
now,
job.
They do say the edge of the ring is the hardest part of the
also
ring.
Also the sharpest. Also the sharpest. Nobody's bothered to dull that. That would be too much money in the fight.
Right.
Oh, here
yeah,
we go.
Locking it in.
With the half crab here.
Liliana.
Also my preferred order at Olive Garden, the half crab.
The half crab at Olive Garden?
Half crab.
Are you thinking of Red Lobster?
I bring my own crab with me. I ask the chef to boil it.
What's up?
Also, they have lobsters in Italy. I'm almost sure of it.
I thought you were eating crab, not lobster.
Are they different? Are you making up animals right now?
Puma.
They both do this.
Is that
puma thing? Hey, Ruck, what's the name of that Mexican lizard? Eats all the ducks.
Captain? Yeah.
That's it. Grip. Tricky thing. How about that one?
Got tusks.
Unfortunately, showing our age here at the at all C3W. Back to the action. Cameo with the old neck flip.
Yeah, there. Still trying to work it out by herself here. Can Phyrexia pick up even a single elimination this match?
Yep, Cameo still going impressively. Oh, falls down to the back pain. I did that some mornings as well. You get up, try to go to work, and just can't do it. Oh, focusing on the back.
Wandering my life in my oar.
That's right.
Cameo observing the carnage. Tagging Kaya. Is Kaya going to put this away with another regicide?
Let's see. Oh!
This is the setup here. Let's go for the pinfall. Don't even need it. Don't need the regicide.
Oh, he needs to kick out. Let's see if Kaya can do some you can't see me action with the ghost form stuff. Gonna
quick meditation.
I've never seen this in the middle of a match.
By the cops are there. He's punched drunk now.
Bold moves. Bold moves, Yahara. Let's see how it pays off. Wander
to break it up.
Ready to step in, though. That's the disadvantage of being a 3-on-1.
Cameo is done. She's done. She's going home.
I was
going
to say, looks like they were trying to go get some, but...
Cameo looking for something here.
Setting up the Cameo safekeeping. Oh!
Ooh, Kyle with the reversal.
Right, with the ghost bug. Oh!
All right, on the deck.
A little half DDT, half suplex action going on here.
Here we go, pick her up. Setting up the regicide.
We've seen this before.
Oh, lights out.
Oh, boom to the face, that's got to be it.
Regicide's
got to be it.
And one, two, three.
Yep.
Ladies Planeswalkers.
I didn't factor it coming to this matchup, but it's clear that those boots were made for Planeswalkers.
And that's just what they did.
That's just what they did just there. They were made for Planeswalkers. Went to the Walker Texas Ranger kick and landed it square to the jaw. No doubt about that. Wow. What a crazy match. Well, what
a good pair of opening match.
What a great set opening match. Ladies Planeswalkers putting us on the board there. Let's see what the fans think.
Everyone watching at home, let us know what it is matches so far as we get ready to go to our third match here. Crew3 versus Form Rankle.
That's coming up next. Wow.
Some
of the greatest wrestlers.
Oh, we're always ready to rumble here, C3W.
The Lady Planeswalkers, they came ready to rumble today.
All right, and we are back here in the Crew3 Arena, getting ready for our third match here. Third of six matches here.
Just incredible.
Crew3 versus Tobrankle over legal disputes. And we are ready to go down.
That's right.
For our next match here.
Reminder that if Tor Branco loses this one, they're out of C3W.
They
no longer have a job. Can we call it a job if we don't pay them?
Legally, no.
Legally, no. But illegally,
yes.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can say
all right,
that.
And we are back down here.
Already got the matchup ready to go. Obviously, this being the most hyped matchup, these wrestlers are ready to go.
Now, of course, Tor Branco. Roku in the third here, Oko joining the mix.
That's right. I can't believe we see Oko back out here, to be honest with you.
I thought we were done with him, but this is once again, we're breaking, going against the rules.
That's right.
Why we need to get rid of them
right. And
get them out of C3W.
Once and for all. Obviously, our three great heroes here, Rick and Chris and Ruckman,
right.
Ready to do their absolute best.
Truly.
To kick these riffraff out of C3W.
Sound like it is, CR.
Oh, we're telling them. You know me. All I'm doing is serving up piping hot truths over here. Okay, this is the truth wagon. All aboard choo-choo. Choo-choo. That's me pumping the horn. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah. That's me right there. All right, here we go. Ready to watch these exciting entries.
Boys. Of course, current tax champion, $10 million.
The following contest
big fans of Love and the University of Texas there.
All the way to the ring. At a combined weight of 900.
They walk out. I don't think I've ever heard the crowd here louder than they are right now. Truly. For these three heroes right here.
And Ricky, the undisputed.
Of course, these gentlemen know best for truly just bringing the Pioneer format to the forefront of Magic the Gathering.
That's right.
Heroes, I've heard they pay their taxes on time. Volunteer.
Pay all their employees.
Pay all their employees, yep. Volunteer every now and again. Just three stand-up individuals.
But I might stop this, I might pause the stream here. See what's going on. Give us 1 second, everyone. We'll be right back. We're looking stable. All right, let's get back to the Crew 3 action. All right, here they come. Here comes Torbrankle.
Here they come.
I mean, just look at the ridiculous thing they're going to make.
That's exactly right. What the hell is this right here? Oh my god.
It spits in the face of everything we've tried to establish here at C3W.
Exactly. This is inappropriate, arguably. Oh god. Oh, turn away. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. I apologize sincerely, ladies and gentlemen.
And pretty
hello, pancakes.
Yeah, where'd he get those?
Where'd he get those?
That was our candy.
That was supposed to be our breakfast. Stolen by Oko, Mr. Steal Your Elk. You don't want to eat those pancakes, though. They're going to be turned into elks.
Yeah. Corbett is swimming in the middle of the ring.
Swimming in the middle of the ring. Nonsensical. They clearly don't even take this seriously. More gyrating for no
catchy
reason.
Catchy music, though, I tell you what.
Catchy music, indeed. More frolicking around the ring.
Absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah. The fans booing massively.
All right. Let's start things off here.
All right.
Rankle using haste there to get in.
Yep, that haste, you know. Coming in to get in there for the low blow. Oh, a swift move out of the way. Woo. Oh, there we go.
Right hook for the job.
Exactly right. Oh, yeah. Our hero starting it off right. A little angle slam suplex there. Picking up Rankle. Oh! Oh, no. There we go.
Boy corner. Tag into Ricky.
You don't have to worry too much about anything going on here.
Stop across the face.
Oh, focusing on that weak leg. You know, those fairy legs.
Famously brutal.
Famously brutal. The fairy rogue legs. Not, that and their wings, not too strong. Great place to focus for our boys.
Right.
Obviously, strategical masterminds. These three men are right here.
Talk and Pioneer World.
That's exactly right. The top of the food chain. Ricky, quick reversal into the turnbuckles there.
Tagging in Torbrand. Probably the only real threat on Team Torbrand is Torbrand.
Probably so.
It's a very big, dense lad.
That's exactly right. And obviously, they do a lot of stretches, those gyrations. They keep you limber, you know? Much more limber than I am right now.
Insane amounts of cardio.
Insane amounts of cardio, that's right. Oh, a little boot to the midsection there, but no worries. Ricky's got this.
Full faith in Ricky.
Oh, why so serious, says Torbrand, making him a smile there. Ricky's had enough. He powers his way out.
Woo! You know he's strong when he kicks him.
That's exactly right. Not lacking strength, that's for sure.
Well, the treasure neck break there.
Come on, ref. Come on, Mike. Step in here. Oh, there
Mike,
we go.
What are we not paying you before.
That's exactly right. That's exactly right. Oh, here you go. This looks promising. There you go.
Take it back to the corner. Get the boys ready.
Boom. Knee to the back of the head. Chris approves, that's for sure.
Right. Ricky just walking all over him.
Resting that arm.
Ooh, Chris tagging in.
That's right.
This, of course, is not an elimination tag match.
No, it is not.
One pinfall is all you need.
That's right. Flip there to Chris.
Right to the back of the neck.
That's right.
Wilder's just not living.
That's true. Chris, not the strongest, and the back is currently his weak point. I can attest to that. But also the most agile of the group.
Very true.
You're much more likely to see more top rope action, more high flying, more speed out of Chris.
Chris saying no way. He's trying to put his match away.
That's right. Oh, yeah. There it is. Oh, man. Yeah, Gorbrand not coming back from this one. He's got a little cha-cha elbow there.
Right.
Serving it up Dora the Explorer style. Cha-cha-cha. Boom.
Look out.
That's okay. Chris Cooley let that happen. Cooley setting up for something in the long term.
That's the plan.
That's the plan.
Plan. Strip the loss. Strip the loss.
That's right. The plan designed to kill Cusco.
Poison?
Specifically designed to kill Cusco. That's right, with poison.
Was Torbrand setting up here? Setting up something. Ooh, running powerbomb.
Yes, right.
Chris kicks out, though.
Kicks out. No problems there. No problems there. Still got plenty left in the tank, obviously.
Torbrand going for the left arm there. They might have Chris scouted this match.
It might have, but I'm going to tell you that tagging in Wrinkle, not the decision I would have made. Chris does a quick little worm action there. Knocks Oko off the ring. Oh, cool backflip. Chris not mounting much of an offense right so, far, up to this point.
The opposite of the fight though.
Yeah, yeah.
All block, no gas.
All block, no gas, that's right. All breaks. There's a good reversal. You like to see it. Oh. Wrinkle looked like he was giving Chris a hug. Chris accepts and tricks him into a little choke slam looking thing there.
Wrinkle stuck on the ropes.
Stank in the ropes. Wrinkle flies right through him.
Yeah.
You know, he's got those wings. Those wings help him whenever they're stuck in the ropes there. There you go. Chris just playing with himself far. Gets out of the way. Look at him manhandling Wrinkle here.
Chris playing with himself. It's the average Friday night.
That's exactly right. Flip him, going to the back, but misses.
This is Wrinkle, Torbrand, and Oko versus the boys.
That's right. Woo. There you go. Chris jumps up, gets the
rounding.
Wrong
and
one.
And busts him open. Yeah.
Oh, wow. This is no good.
Two. We'll kick out of two.
The fairy's kicking out, though. Oh, a low blow. Mike, where's playing?
Mike is letting all balls come.
Yeah, Mike is letting him play. Woo, the F5 looking thingy there. Chris crawling towards the ropes.
Rolling him over.
Woo. A little suplex action. Nothing Chris hadn't seen before.
Chris hasn't been a lot of offense on this match.
No, but Chris, a veteran of the Jun pile.
Jun pile, that's right.
It don't count just yet,
that's right.
Okay?
He's used to being pounded by plenty of men.
Especially when they try and make U-turns on overpasses.
Right. The true Jun pile happening in the ring right now.
Uh-oh, wavering Mike down. It's a madhouse in here. Who's in, who's out?
Oh, Wrinkle punch drunk right now.
Wrinkle tagging in Oko. Chris has done a lot of elk hunting, though, in the past. Oh, wow. Sit down.
The seasoned elk hunter.
That's exactly right. We call him the elk hunter around these parts. Finally mounting some offense here. Gets a reversal. Staring him dead in the eyes.
Yes, that's right.
Wants him to know that he is not afraid. That's right. Waits for him to come out of the store. The store delivers the stunner. That's the move we've been waiting to see.
Get him away from the corner here.
That's exactly right. And goes for the pin. Two.
Oh, come on. Kick it. Very rare we see a kick out of the stunner.
Very rare we see the stunner, one of the most powerful moves in C3W.
Rutland coming in here. Let's see if the
working current, on that shoulder a little bit.
The current $1 million champion.
That's right.
Tell him to stay down.
Owner of Damien. Ooh, a high flying DDT there from Oko. Some intense action.
Rutland clearly not expecting Oko to turn around like this.
Yeah. The agility of Oko on display here. One of the reasons that Oko was banned for so long.
I mean, it makes sense. Oko. Classic underrated upon these.
That's
Rutland
right.
They're falling for the same shenanigans.
Yep. But quickly gets up out of the, Oh! You see that agility there? I've never seen Rutland move so fast. That's exactly right. Rutland maybe igniting his planeswalker spark there. Who's to say? Oh, a big swing and a miss from Rutland there. Woo! Ruckman's so strong, when he gets clotheslined during the turnbuckle, and takes the other wrestlers out with him.
All right. Oko dragging Ruckman to the middle of the ring here.
Oh, that did not look good, whatever that was.
Certainly did not press.
No. Oh, oh man. He's
fancy
feet
here.
Ricky, not looking like he's going to stand for this. Just kidding. Ricky does want to stand for it.
Ruckman breaks out.
Woo! Ricky throws him down like it's nothing. He seems to walk out.
Oh, ref, get right glad here. Orban, the leading man now.
That's right. Oh! Did wind up a punch. Telegraph that punch, you might say.
The sun salutation.
Yeah, exactly right. Looked like some kind of spirit bomb action. Gathering the power. A little flipping whip right there from Torbrand. One crucial thing we're forgetting is that all of Torbrand's attacks deal an extra 2 damage.
Yeah.
Crucial.
The internal damage is adding up.
That's right.
Wow, here we go.
Quick. It's incremental damage.
Here we go. This is true teamwork right here.
Yes, it is. Oh. Oh, boy.
Triple power bomb.
I'm glad that was going somewhere. I was starting to get a little worried why we were just crouching for so long there. Uh-oh.
Franco breaking it up.
Franco breaking it up. Ricky not having it. Ricky throwing him over. Ruck is going to be disappointed with that one. A lot of setups for that powerful move. Just to have the cheaters come in and take away from him. A sit-out power bomb, though, by Ruckman. A fantastic move.
Ricky wants back in this match.
Everybody begging
they
for the tag.
They both in. Oko coming in here.
Wrinkle seems to be
MIA.
Ruckman
make the tag before Oko drags him away. Let this happen?
That's a good question. Apparently the answer is yes.
I know I paid a server code.
A distinct lack of teamwork here from C3W.
Are these cracks forming in C3W?
It might be the case. The invasion seems to be going strong here.
Ruckman taps! Oko wins!
Ruckman taps out to the Oko! And we just seen the impossible. Ricky's clearly unhappy. Chris clearly unhappy. Truly a stunner.
A platform with C3W.
You'll have to tune in next time to find out.
That's right.
Chris delivers one stunner. Oko delivers the next with a ankle lock to make Ruckman tap out.
If he didn't fall down those stairs 2 weeks ago, that wouldn't happen.
That's true. Obviously, the
Ruckman and Chris both working with him.
Two-thirds of the boys coming in injured here.
Here are your winners, the Jester, Knight, and Pretty Boy, the Hooligan.
All right. Let's get on to this next matchup.
All right. You know, we're already in the Satisfactory Blowdown.
That's right.
All right, our next match.
You know, one downside to the Crew 3 Arena here that we've improvised here in Dallas, Texas. Not a ton of air conditioning, it would seem.
That's correct.
Not a ton of air conditioning. Should have brought some fans. Now, we needed to have the servo tokens fan-ness.
This is going to be a very big fan-requested matchup here. This is the lovers match between Chandra and Nyssa in Hell in a Cell.
In Hell in a Cell.
In Hell in a Cell.
Wow. By God.
Let's take it on down.
You might say. Queuing up the action quick here. Let's observe what's going on around us here at the Crew 3 Arena.
That's some Counter-Strike. No, that's Valor. No, that's Counter-Strike. We got some Toontown.
Toontown, the classic.
Hungry Box on the Pyramid.
Hungry Box on the Pyramid.
All right, and we're heading down the ring. Of course, that honor structure being Hell in a Cell.
Oh, God. I get nervous just looking at it. Becky Lynch, of course, the inventor of the Hell in a Cell.
Right.
The artist.
The following contest is a Hell in a Cell match.
The fan decided to just go as
always.
And obviously, that's that performance. Ricky's going to need something to cheer him up a little
bit. Right. Hope he's got his W here.
Hopefully so.
And also, please, once again, love wins.
Love wins. That's exactly right. Connor taking a lap around the ring real quick.
Taking it out.
Taking it out. Gideon indeed rolling in his grave.
R.I.P. Gideon.
Great call out. R.I.P. Oh no. Something nobody ever wanted to see.
That's right.
The Rexian eyes.
Unfortunately, couldn't give her forearms.
Disappointing. We had to confiscate the extra two.
That's right.
You'd have a maximum of two arms allowed. And they must not be also knives.
Correct.
Must be regular fists.
Do not have swords for hands.
Right.
Hell in a Cell action. Let's go.
Action ready to pop off. Wavering Mark. Wavering Mike tells him to start. Nyssa coming out strong.
Oh.
Immediately a knee to the back.
Kick right to the back there.
Another one. Wow. Clearly Nyssa targeting something here that we don't know.
I mean, these competitors, they know each other quite intimately.
That what they do.
Mark, they're working the leg.
Oh, needed to face that time.
Can Chandra beat Nyssa? That's what we're here to establish today.
We're here to find out. Obviously, Chandra feeling a little hesitant, you might say. Not so sure.
She is the hope's bacon.
The hope's bacon. That's right. Do we have any bacon sponsors for this matchup here?
Jimmy Dean.
That's right. Going for an early roll-up.
Whoa, Chandra.
Finally starting to get fighting back here. Obviously, in this matchup, we're looking for Chandra's signature move, the fire design.
Right.
That's right. We're trying to come out and finish off this here.
Oh. Fire design being a signature arm ball.
That's right. Had to name a wrestler obviously in the regular world,
yeah,
that most reminds you of Chandra and their, you know, list of moves that they currently have.
Uh-huh.
What wrestler would you say that would be?
Becky Lynch,
that's right. Current sponsor of the Hell in the Cell here.
Nyssa is swatting Chandra away there on that drop kick. Oh, she's dead. She's dead.
Nobody's coming back from this. Missa climbing to the top ropes here. Oh! Woo! That looked painful. This might be over already.
Two.
Oh, and a kick out by Chandra.
Chandra kicks out.
Nuthead, fighting for love. The fans are already putting in requests for next time. We've got a Squee versus Krovax match request.
I'll make that happen.
Another backflip off the top ropes. How much more of this can Chandra take?
Two. Kick out again at two.
Kick out at two.
Now, as much as these kickouts are very important, but of course, burning a lot of energy every time.
True. True. Chandra just
shoved out, just teleporting out of the ring.
Yeah, teleporting out of the ring there. Flames walking out.
Unfortunately for her, Hell in a Cell. Not as capable as Planeswalker.
Right, not as capable as Planeswalker. That cage is made specifically to contain Planeswalkers. Just like the poison design specifically to kill Kuzma.
Well, here it is, fire design.
The fire design armor.
Locked in. Missed escapes.
Oh! A switch around DDT there. Chandra feeling hype now.
Definitely feeling fired up.
Feeling fired up. Woo! A little clothesline action. Clothesline number two.
Oh, running clotheslines in a drop kick.
That's right. Oh, ooh. A little suplex action there.
Launching this across the ring there.
One. Right. Roll up.
Two. Got a two. I'm looking for something here. Going back for the fire design. She's locked in.
This looks deep right here. This looks deep.
And this attack.
Oh my gosh.
Love wins once again here on 3-3.
Love wins again. I was just about to say, looks like we were rolling in the deep there, much like that Adele song, with how deep that lock-in was. Chandra looked defeated the whole time, but this goes to show, never give up.
Never give up.
Never surrender.
That's exactly right.
Knowledge is power.
Knowing is half the battle,
right? All those classics, of course, of course, of course. There's Nissa off the top rope a couple times there. Oh, and this is the deep one. That is the
locker it is.
It is fired by. There's the throw, and then here we're coming up here. The replay of the final fire design armbar here. And of course, there's the kick out by Nissa. And of course, the celebration, the excitement for Chandra.
No.
They lifted the cage.
Yeah.
Amazing. She's free. Amazing.
All right, we have two last questions, James.
Two more matches.
And you're not going to want to miss it. First up is our men's tag elimination match of Kaivar, Kopp, and Teferi versus Tybalt, Luka, and Ajani.
And Ajani, okay.
Let's see the match up here.
All right, guys, how have you liked the wrestling so far? Let us know as our wrestlers get ready for this next matchup.
All right, here we go, our next match.
Already ready, the wrestlers standing on by.
My flesh cat. Observe the flesh cat.
I don't want to observe. I'm done observing. Bold move to get tattoos right across the nipples there. You can see all that here in this area. I don't currently have my little telestrator.
That's right, yeah.
Where I can draw circles on things. They took that away from me from drawing dicks on too many things.
I was going to say, yeah.
Yep.
You know why you lost it.
I know why I
After
lost it.
After the incident.
That's on me. That's on me. What a strikingly lifelike Ajani. That's all you can say about that.
Luka clearing the hole in his brain.
Yep.
Oh.
trying to get hyped up for this matchup.
What's your prediction of this matchup?
What's that?
What's your prediction of this matchup?
You know, there's a lot of signs in the crowd, a lot of shiny things that Donnie's going to get distracted by. I think I like the opposing team of this one. Kibble, known as one of the weaker planeswalkers.
Right. The most perennial weaker in CCW.
That's right.
What do you get from metal arm?
That's right.
Luckily though, currently, Taxi Invasion, C3W leads 2-1.
That's right. That's right. Currently fighting them off.
This match, technically deciding match here, the win here at C3W ties up, or wins for the victory, no matter the outcome.
That's right.
Of Ellsworth versus Ellsworth. But,
That's right. You never know. Weighing in at 360 pounds. Anything feels possible at this point of the night.
Really.
The atmosphere is electric.
Great crowd here in Dallas, Texas.
Great crowd here, that's for sure. No, not much air conditioning or snacks.
Right. No snacks.
Would love for somebody to bring us a monster and a drink. Letting us know.
I did see Servo Dozen walking by a minute ago. I wonder if he could go grab a monster.
That would be wonderful for Servo Dozen to grab a monster and a drink. And deliver it to us personally. That would make us happy. What else are Servo Tokens for? Have to wait for the rest of the entrances here. Lucas celebrating early here. Maybe it's this. Here we go. There's Flesh to Johnny. Ready to wreak havoc.
Weighing in at 408 pounds, Goldman.
Where we put the litter box?
It's under the ring.
It's under the ring. There we go. But we also keep the chairs.
That's right. The real question is, did you shoot the litter box?
What's that? I would never do that.
For sure, it comes to form.
That's exactly right. All of our menial tasks taken by Servo Token.
Right.
Waiting for the intros to finish here. Before we jump straight into the action.
And his opponent. He's running his way down to the ring. From
Olympian Steel. I'm ready to brawl.
Weighing in at 220 pounds.
Woo, cool celebration there. You gotta love the fire.
Right. Again, did we encourage that pyro?
Pyro has definitely been approved. That's 100% confirmed. I'm hearing in my ear right now. I don't know, can't make it out. Servo Token was trying to say something. I don't speak robot, so no idea what they were trying to say to me.
Fair enough. Let it ride.
Let it ride. Okay, now that I'm looking closer, those tattoos definitely not right on top of the nips there.
They just avoid
the nips. Famously of the hammer.
Right.
People want to know what time it is. He says,
hammer time.
Hammer time.
So fire these bitches.
We're firing them. What would you say are the key points in this matchup here?
So if I am Keith Lane's Rocker,
right,
I'm only worried about Johnny.
Yeah.
Sybil, buffoon.
Yeah.
Luca is an idiot.
Right.
But Johnny, only real credible threat they have.
Fair.
So they need to get a Johnny out of this match early and take control of things.
I love it.
And who's gonna help with that? The fairy. The animal's back, baby.
Oh wow, the fairy in here.
Phase back in just in time.
Phase back in just in time. Using that time magic.
From another time, weighing in at 217 pounds, the future.
Here after Valky Pope, after opposing his Valky, God of Lies.
Of course. Tyvar looks real happy. You might say jubilant to be in this ring brawling.
And ready for a brawl, that's right.
Ready for a brawl. That's all there is to it. Valky, though, starting off with some elbow stomps here. Good reversal. Tyvar into the ropes. Oh, getting some dirty punches there. Oh!
Take it to the down.
Good takedown. Working on that wrist is Tyvar. Working on the non-metal one, intelligent. Right. That metal one, pretty strong.
You don't want to start there. That's
don't want to start there, that's for sure. Oh! Big knee drop. Big knee drop by Tyvar. Tyvar maybe just wants to take on this whole match himself.
And he will, if he has to.
He has the option. Uh-oh, Wavering Mark. Mark.
Mike.
Wavering Mike's brother. Who we had to replace here, yeah. Valky, that trickster. Using an illegal hold there. Now going to wander around the match. Not really sure what to do.
AI stuck. Frazzled, even. Tagging and Luca, bold decision.
Bold decision.
Let's see what this idiot can do.
Oh, there we go. Okay. Looking with a body slam. Goes for double whiffs there. Goes for a stomp. Oh, Luca body slam.
Surprisingly dominant for an idiot.
Into the ropes there. For somebody with no brains.
Almost like you have a free monster delivery.
Incredible savior from the ropes here. One servo token saving the day.
There we go.
You know what we gotta say here? Let the big dog hunt. Bottoms up.
Cheers. What shame.
We get a body slam. We get a leg kick first by Tyvar.
The keys to the bends.
Keys to the bends, says Tyvar.
Yep, yep. Keys to the bends.
Meanwhile, Johnny's saying to the left, to the left. That's where my litter box is.
Very moonwalking in place.
Moonwalking, stunting on him, letting him know. Tyvar still not tagging out yet.
Like you still say, Tyvar wants this whole match to himself.
That's exactly right. Finally tagging in Koff. We get the tag in. Here's Koff from the middle.
Koff at the top of the arm.
Abuse on that arm there. Good little kick to the thigh. Giving him a back massage.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody knows Koff hates shoulder massages.
And he's dead. He's out.
And he's dead. And he's gone. Deciding to just leave it there and tag in to Johnny. We'll see what they've got in store for him here. Oh, Koff not taking it laying down.
Koff playing possum there.
That's right. Getting right back up. Getting his favorite matchup with Johnny.
Ooh, Johnny somehow sliding out.
That's right. Look at those agile-like things. As
cat-like
we know,
reflexes.
That's right. Cat-like reflexes. As we know, all of Johnny's have 9 lives. Wondering why Tyvar was sitting there watching that, then picks him up, goes for a running body slam.
Tyvar waiting, not wanting to jump Koff in line for the smash.
That's right. Koff with drop kick does not seem very effective against Steve Johnny. Oh, working number 5.
Taking a run for the flesh cat.
Trying to rip his head off there.
The mood in the crowd is palpable.
The crowd is proud to pop
Luca
off any moment here.
Luca and Tibble both trying to get tagged in here. Luca tagged in.
Luca again, unimpressed for the first time. Let's see if they've got anything better to show us this time. German suplex. Oh, wow. Koff nimble there. To the back goes Luca. Luca,
also
delivery, and nobody's home.
Koff took his Johnny off the turf.
Did he just do the Captain Insano eye poke there?
I think he did.
Wow.
Captain Insano, your favorite wrestler.
My favorite wrestler, obviously known for showing no mercy.
Koff set something up here.
Oh, scissor kick.
Cross the back of the neck.
I'd say he scissor kicked his gizzards. And
Luca
the kick out.
Kick it out.
Kick it out by Luca. Not going down that easy.
Luca say my boat can be there.
That's right.
Tyvar tagged in once again. Tyvar doing a lot of work for planeswalking this match.
Wow. Whoa, look at the showboating. The showboating by Tyvar.
Not even looking.
That's right, the no-look drop.
Cool guys don't look at dropping your opponents.
That's exactly right. Everybody knows that. That's rule 3 of C3W. Rule 1, you're not getting paid.
That's right.
Intelligently dragging Luca back to the middle of the ring here. Oh, good reversal.
That's
by Luca.
That's swing IQ you can't do.
That's right. Maybe she's born with it.
I'll tell you what, he was not born with ring tone. Righty tokes it all.
That's right.
Luca.
Nope. Nothing going on up there in that empty brain.
When Frexy added that light bulb, it was an improvement.
It was an improvement, that's right. Luca stomping on Tyvar here. Okay. Luca's had enough of us making fun of him. He's bringing it to Tyvar here. Oh, Tyvar put up some blocks though. Okay, Hey, Luca, look what they were stocking Kaivar. Just needed to walk it out a little bit.
Johnny.
In comes the champ.
Luca holding him down. Oh, knee right to the gut there.
That's right.
Kaivar trying to go, going right to the knee.
Right there.
Right in the exposed kneecap.
A Johnny in the corner. Nobody puts a Johnny in the corner. Except for Kaivar.
Ooh, working the arm.
Good arm breaker again. I don't think we've seen Teferi at all this match. Waiting for Teferi to phase back in.
You are right, Chris. I don't think we have seen Teferi at all in this matchup.
Oh,
right on the face.
Looks like an interesting version of the Alabama Slam. Headbutt straight there. Break the cough.
Mercy me, it is hot.
Oh my gosh, it is warm in here. It is warm in here. Thank you. Much needed. Okay.
Woo!
Here we go.
Out there, take a lot of feather spin.
Going straight for the ribs. Whoa, right to the ribs again.
Now they got Teferi. Wait, Teferi? Right now, Teferi's the only person here on a full tank gas, so you have to save that.
That's right. Ooh, climbing the top rope. Luca, cheater that he is.
Waver and Mark. Of course, twin brother Waver and Mike.
That's right.
Just gonna let it happen.
Just gonna let it happen. Waver's right through those two wrestlers, as you saw.
And Johnny clearly out of it, still trying to make the pinfall here.
Yeah, trying to make it. Can't make it. It's a two count right there.
Oh, ooh, Buster Johnny open.
Those eyes gonna be more bloodshot. Of course, we did test Johnny for feline HIV before we allowed them in the match.
And what did the test say?
They were inconclusive.
Okay.
Not enough to stop them from wrestling.
All right. But you test positive for cat diabetes.
That's right. Oh! Goes over the top there. Johnny picking up cough. Oh, running clotheslines. Let's see what Johnny's got in store. So far, Kaivar is in the dominant force in this matchup.
Hawk running right into Luca's knee.
That's right. Okay, Johnny's
looking for something. Ooh, pump handle DDT.
Okay.
Hawk is dead.
Hawk, not looking good. Goes for the pinfall. Let's see what happens. Two. Three.
Hawk has been eliminated.
Okay.
Three on two right now.
Teferi making its way into the matchup.
Kaivar, get out of the ring, you scumbag. Teferi seemed to work the ring. The injured knee of the Johnny.
All right. Teferi bringing it to him. The first time we've seen Teferi really in this matchup. Oh, big body slam. How much more can Johnny take?
If Teferi had this match earlier, would we already be done by now?
Who's to say? Wavering Mark, a little bit newer.
Yeah, that's right.
To the wrestling game.
Of course, once Teferi is on the field, he does force your opponent to play inferior card game.
That's exactly right. Sit down powerbomb by Teferi. Strong move. One of the best he's got. What kind of signature move are we looking for out of Johnny here today?
Really looking for the discontinuity.
Discontinuity, okay. Let's see what Johnny's got for us. So far, just taking a lot of punishment. Camera's facing away from us. I can't see this claw maneuver. Whatever it is, doesn't look good. Teferi finally knocked off. Aggie and Tibble
Very bold, very brave. Let's see if it pays off.
Perry in the corner. Oh! Running elbow to the corner by Tibble.
Tibble dropping for Perry there.
Yeah. Some strong moves here. But the Perry rolls out of the stomp, notably.
Johnny looking pretty rough on the ring ropes there.
Yep. All these wrestlers do seem tired.
I will tell you this at this matchup. There's only one elimination.
Good note. We need to see a minimum of two more eliminations, possibly more, in order to finally get this match. Oh, Teferi, you see that shifted out of the way. Clearly phased out very rapidly there. Woo! Teferi ducks out the clothesline. But takes a gash in the face. Teferi in the corner. Running elbow to the face there. Again, Teferi shifts out the way.
The early numbers advantage gives the Phyrexians a clear sign of victory here.
Obviously, it's going to be easier with, you know, one man up on the enemy team, but you just never do know. Tyvar is still in the match. Tyvar has really been putting forth a fantastic effort.
Tyvar is the workhorse of his craft.
That's exactly right. Big brawler.
Shot collar.
Yeah, 20-inch blades on the Impaler. All right, Valky going to the top rope.
High rent district. Oh. Teferi get the knees up, though.
Oh, that's got to be painful. You don't want to see that. Ooh. Notably in the crowd tonight, not a ton of Phyrexians. In the crowd tonight. Double to the corner, Teferi with a running clothesline into the turnbuckle.
Very high from the crowd, turning the sunset.
That's right.
Bums down, it's over.
Woo! Big sit-out powerbomb from Teferi. Surely that's got to be it. Let's see if he goes for the pinfall. He will. Wavering marks on top of him. Johnny entering the friend zone. Oh!
Breaking Johnny breaking up the pinfall there.
Breaking up. Teferi very displeased, obviously. Wavering mark, probably close to some disqualifications here. Good elbow, clearly hurt Tibble there as well.
Wavering might clearly go to the competitors. I'm going to need you to make a decision or slow play will.
That's exactly right. Slow playing is being called here. Tibble dragging the pair into the center of the ring.
Going for submission here. Perry rolls out of it.
Out. Look at that robot. Beautifully done. Teferi.
Take Tibble to the corner.
To the turnbuckle. Powerful maneuver.
Tag in Tyvar.
Tyvar double team.
In stereo on the knees.
Wow. To the double. Let's see if they can earn a pinfall on that one. Tibble not mounting a lot of offense. But surely has
Tibble.
Picked up.
Tyvar got Tibble to submission. Gauntlet lock. Ooh, Tibble wiggles his way out of it.
Tibble wiggles with a little trickster he is. Straight back in the corner. Oh,
he's dead. Oh, no, he's up.
He's up. Let's see if we go for another submission here. Oh, the reversal.
Ivar takes extra damage.
Okay, Tibber.
Tibble sends something up here. Ooh, Ivar with the...
Oh, reversal into the clothesline. That surely is it. Tibble can't take any more.
Going for the shoulder crank.
Let's see. Wavering mark on the call. Tyvar gives it up. Wants to go for some more damage elsewhere. Ooh. Jumping body slam. Tibble thankfully just rolls over for him. Making the easy pin here.
Luca. Doing something right for the first time in his life.
That's right. Looks like three to me, but of course the interlopers there made this a lot harder.
Perry coming to finish off the job.
Okay, Perry coming in here. I'm expecting to see a pinfall soon, folks. This has been a lot of action. Perry setting up the second son here. Okay. setting up another sit-out powerbomb.
Sunset over Zalfir.
There it is. Oh, my goodness. Surely, there's no way he comes back from this. That's the third, I believe, sit-out powerbomb we've seen.
Tibble's out. We are tied up 2-2.
Luka in here. Luka comes in. Immediately gets dumpstered. Woo! Look at those stomps. That's true. That's so good. Just the fairy just got in his way.
His chest cavity in.
Luka, nothing without their furry companion.
Right.
Oh, the neck breaks.
I think it's very vital.
I also think it's very vital. It's tricky. Preparing clotheslining Luka here. Good shoulder check.
Those football pads are good use.
Luka, we're not sure if he's a Phyrexian Eyes or a massive Dallas Stars fan. Luka can't take any more attacking in the big hand of Johnny. So far, it's fair to say that Johnny's done most of the heavy lifting here.
Johnny immediately coming in, taking very dominant position in this matchup.
That's right, taking control. Going to work on the leg of the fairy there.
Control from the control deck. Derry not able to call Yorian to reset the stakes.
That's
here.
Exactly right. Oh, good running clothesline.
Oh, neck break.
Wow. Johnny looks a little dazed. We'll be seeing mice with that last hit. Oh, straight to the paw.
Thinking, maybe I should have bought a boat.
Maybe you should have bought a boat. That's right. Johnny going to be looking for the litter box after this matchup. There's a knee to the face. Ooh. Another backbreaker there by Teferi. Picking up Adani. Oh, good elbow. Oh, wow. Headbutt. The good news is we did make sure that Adani bathed himself before this matchup.
In fact, he did. Teferi, all right. Put him down, Luka.
That's it. Body slam. Impressive maneuvers from the fairy here.
That spear.
Oh, okay, good spear.
What are we setting up here, fairy?
What are we setting up?
There we go. Wow. Lock it in.
Yep. It's like you said before. The fairy is playing at instant speed. His opponent said he'd be playing Hearthstone.
Right. Luka, though, breaking out.
Showing signs of life. Teferi in the corner. Nobody puts Teferi in the corner. Oh, head to the turnbuckle.
Careful with that ring pivot. That cost us money.
That's right. Ivar begging for the tag. Goes for it. Gets the tag. Here comes
Ivar's in.
Immediately delivers a big clothesline. Big shoulder check. Look at that going here.
All right.
Throws Tyvar across the ring.
Tyvar around.
There we go.
Tyvar impressive here.
Not taking it sitting down, that's for sure. Off the rope. Ooh, good body slam. No one level going for the quick pin. But Johnny looking to step in and does so. Johnny
breaks it up.
Tyvar tries to get a little piece on the way out, but unsuccessful. What's Tyvar going for here? Slips off the ring, quickly slips back in. Luka delivering some punches. Slips Tyvar to the turnbuckle. Oh, good reversal by Tyvar. Straight boot in the face here. Teferi getting back up.
Set up for a tag. Ooh, slamming Tyvar. They got Teferi hot tag.
Teferi gets tagged in. Crew3 goes for a reversal unsuccessful. Gets some. We're done. Looking taking him up. Oh, good swing by the side.
One going for the pin.
Two.
Very kicks out.
Kicks out of the very
just
last
barely.
Thing. Looks like a three count to me, but you never can be sure. Wavering Mike with the most modern count. Obviously, we're on a slight delay up here in the booth.
Right.
It's a very,
very sit-out powerbomb.
Another sit-out powerbomb.
Sunset over Zalf here. Is that going to put Luka away?
Oh, that's the fourth one of the match. Let's see if that puts it in here. Two. Three.
All right, Luka's out of there.
Okay.
Very big boot.
Okay, there we go. Johnny with the reversal. Knees to the back. Fighting like it's his last life.
With a 3-on-2, now a 2-on-1.
Uh-oh.
Now the turn tables.
With the reversal. Into the reverse DDT.
Like Sans the Hourglass, these are the days of our lives.
These are the days of our lives.
Very Sans the sunset over South here.
Another sunset.
Oh my god.
I feel like DJ Khaled. I feel like DJ Khaled because we're just seeing another one after another one.
Back in the middle of the ring.
Let's see it.
One. Two, three.
After
several sessions, five sessions of Rizal here.
Wow.
This is a 5-year son from Dearden and over Zalf.
It makes sense. The lore all adds up here. Yep.
Come on, ref indeed.
Yep. This is Wavering Mark. Wavering Mike's brother. Slash cousin. Amazing. Amazing performance by Teferi. Really, Tyvar opened up that match.
Right.
Teferi finished, if you want to think about it that way.
A true control player.
A true control player, that's right. Do we need to go to a commercial break for a minute? Maybe stretch a little bit or something like that?
I think we're good if you need to.
Sure.
I think we roll on here for our last
six and final matchup. Let's see it.
All right.
I'm going to adjust myself here.
Yeah.
Fans, how are you liking this matchup? Let us know what you're looking to see.
As you're ready for our last match, Elish Norn versus Elspeth. All right, everyone, thank you for joining us. As I said, we are heading into our final match for the
last
here tonight. This matchup was, of course, Elspeth versus Elish Norn for the Crew3 W Women's Championship.
Women's Championship on the line.
Last woman standing match.
Well, there's only two of them.
One shall stand.
One shall fall. It makes sense
Sponsor
to me.
Sponsor Transformers, Rise of Beasts.
That's right. One plus one, that's two. Quick mass.
You're gonna at least hear Elsa.
Okay,
it's
I'm gonna
hear it.
It's
pretty good.
Let's get in here. Listen in. Elthorn got 2 teeth and no toothbrush. Mom said that's why she's so ornery.
Right.
Listening in here, live to the entrance. Waiting for our competitors to be ready. And from the looks of our bars, they were about 50%. Jumped to 100% ready.
Right.
And
live Dallas, Texas. And George Dreamhack and I was out here this weekend. It is only Friday. We are going to be here for two more days. Of course, this is our only stream slot, but
only
you can find
slot.
Us hanging around, walking around, playing magic, having lots
right.
of fun here.
Come say hi.
Here we go.
If you can throw text on, you can throw our Twitch stream on the screen since we're live behind us here also. Take this. I'm going to listen in on my thing here. So I can hear a little bit better. Get around the hat as best as I can. It's truly a glorious history.
Right.
If you had to compare Elspeth,
okay,
to the moveset of a modern day real life wrestler, who would you closest compare this to?
Charlotte Flair.
Charlotte Flair. Amazing.
Which I think so.
At least we think so.
Right. Compared to a lot of wrestlers to a lot of...
Right. A lot of work's gone into this. Like I said, a whole 45 minutes worth.
please respect my 140 dollars in this game.
Yeah, exactly right. Exactly right. Amazing. A lot of celebrations. Obviously.
We'll defend and do what she must.
That's right. Elspeth really fighting for everybody here. Looking to take out current women's champion.
Ellis Norn.
Mother of the team.
Third.
What? Okay. Here's the current champion. See it. Look at that dainty little spin there. Walking with all the confidence. Look at those boots.
Right.
This might be the most fashionable wrestler we've seen all night.
If you thought a Johnny was out, just wait to see the rest of her.
Wait to see this. Ella Storm obviously famous for crippling her opponent.
Cartwheels.
While doubling her own. Look at that split. Impressive. And here we are.
Mother Machines is here to defend her title and secure her claim over C3W.
That's right. Women's Championship on the line here.
Introducing the challenger from Elysian Fields, Angel. Introducing the champion from the pits of hell, the Raw Women's Champion, the Machine.
Atwood? Yes, what is up? What's going on? Good, I'm doing good. Are you here having some fun? Yeah.
We are.
Yeah, I'll see you around, yeah?
Right.
Wavering mic. This is what it's all about.
This is the actual wavering mic this time. Presenting the title. That is up for grabs. This final match.
Again, still pending sleep rage review.
As it does look like Elshorn got in with some what looks to be illegal looking
claws. Elspeth though. Quick counter. Elspeth here on the play this matchup.
That's right. Elspeth on the play. And as we all know in Pioneer, that's all that matters.
Ask a modern player. They'll tell you.
Ask a modern player. They'll tell you the whole time. The whole time they're losing, they're going to be upset. Oh, the neck crank. Clearly, Elishnor knows that Elspeth's been having recurring neck problems. That's exactly right.
She needs to get a better pillow when she sleeps.
That's exactly right. Was previously using the MyPillow, but as we all know, those don't work.
Those do not work.
Elishnor
there. Elishnor
sending it.
High rent district, high risk, high reward.
That's exactly right. Trying to find it, but nobody was home there. Special delivery missed. Oh, Elspeth just throwing Elishnor around, going for a boot to the face. Elishnor, of course, missing their gigantic freaking sword.
For a head. Look, we work what we have. Again, I have satyr legs and Medusa heads, but not sword heads.
Elspeth also missing their giant sword. They're gonna have to do his old school. Oh, those boots were made for stomping. Elbow to the face. Elspeth setting up a move here. I'm trying to go for an airplane spin.
This is last woman standing.
Which means wavering Mike, ineligible to win based on our current information.
That's correct, yeah.
For the uneducated people at home, because obviously I know exactly what that means,
yes.
Why don't you tell the fans at home
what
a last woman
this,
stand
what this means is, if one of our competitors becomes immobilized, the wavering Mike will start a 10 count here, as you see right now. We're at one, and if he reaches 10, that's out.
That's it.
three.
Or do regular pinfalls count for the people at home?
No.
Okay.
Five.
Six. What comes after six?
We're not going to find out yet.
We're not going to find out.
Leave them waiting.
I wish I had known. Oh, a solid neck break. That was bad. Looked like they were getting hunted. Became the predator. Was the prey. Oh, yep. Feeling off that neck there. Acting like nothing's going on. But that gave Elishnorn time to recover. Elspeth throwing Elishnorn around the map here. Okay. Oh, look at that arm. Did you see that arm vibrating like that? That surely was not...
Trying to phase out here.
Yeah, that was not normal, that's for sure.
We might power man through power fairy tribes to creep.
Yeah.
We might have to skip forward ahead in time a little bit here.
We might have to.
Which, if that's the case, we'll rerun this map in its entirety at a later date.
That's exactly right. If any Teferis are seen present and jump us ahead in time, then we will make sure that you are able to see the entirety of this matchup at some point.
I think we're going to have to. We're going to jump ahead. Fair would cut us in right
now.
I feel something.
Oh
my goodness, we jumped ahead.
What happened here? Okay, it looks like some kind of time magic happened, and we're at a later point in the match.
Elishnorn still in control of this matchup,
still
as far
in control.
As we know.
We've got a count going on there. I can count up to this many, so I think I am good.
Good.
I can follow along.
How many is that, by the way?
I think we're up to this many. And then comes one more finger. Okay.
Okay. That's the sitting up.
Oh. Going to control the matchup currently. Boring out there. Oh, going for the knee. Knee to the abs in there. That's no good. Getting another count here so quickly after the first one. But I believe if I'm right, we only got to about 11 T.
Texas Public Education.
Yeah, we only got about to 11 T last time.
That's right.
Which is not a high enough count.
Seven. Eight.
That's eight right there. I know that one.
Dad, Ocho Cinco.
That's exactly right.
Elspeth reversal, taking out the knee.
Okay. Elspeth maybe playing a little bit dead here, just laying down to get some rest up. And then with the gloat, there we go. That's what I have to believe was happening.
Would you be surprised to find out that Elspeth is Ric Flair's daughter?
I would not be surprised to find that. Okay. Elishnorn down to the count this time.
Patiently watching to make sure.
That's right.
Doesn't want to break the rest of the count here either.
Nope. Let Wavering Mike focus. Obviously, he's, you know, all that unstable energy inside of
him. That's right.
Anything is prone to happen at this point. And Elishnorn right back up. Oh, immediately goes for a variation of the angle slam. Elishnorn, top rope. Setting something up. What you would normally call a frog splash, we call here the mite splash. The mite splash looks strong. Elspeth down again.
She's moving. She's not dead yet. Like a phoenix rising from the ashes.
Rising from the ashes.
Six. Seven. Any second now, Elspeth. Come on, get up. Get up, Elspeth. You can do it.
Okay, Elspeth, back up.
The crowd giving Elspeth all of their energy.
That's
here.
That's right.
Throwing her out of the ring.
Elishnorn following her out of the ring. Gonna get back in the ring for the count. Rest
much
up.
Much safer.
Much safer there. Getting a little rest, obviously. Elspeth, for the last few minutes, has been getting the business in. Four. Five. There's six. Wavering Mike getting closer to keep an eye on things. Getting closer still. Wavering Mike can't get much closer than that, buddy. You're on top of it.
Back up.
Okay. And with that, Elspeth will exit the ring again. Oh, go for a suplex. This is powerful stuff here. Oh, the flip out by Elishnorn.
Woo!
Into a cross body. This is powerful magic we're watching right here.
Very powerful magic.
No free spells here.
I have no prior knowledge. Elishnorn came here off of Bring to Life.
Uh-oh. Okay. That's good. That costs a lot of mana to do that. Alpha again. That looks like a 7 count to me, but I don't know. I can't count.
We're at 8. Back up at 8. All right.
Back up.
Hellish Verse allows her to get back into the ring.
That's right. That's free money right there. GR, what an exciting wisdom match we've had today. Okay, get another count. Mm. At times I have felt a little bit country. At times I have felt a little bit rock and roll.
Oh, that's right.
Which explains my accent change middle of the matches here. Okay, that looks like a 7 count.
8, or up at 8 again.
Okay, but I needed the back from Elspeth.
All right, stomp the back of the head.
Stomp the yard. We love stomping the yard. My favorite movie from 2009.
Go to the top rope. Elbow off the top rope.
Elbow from the top rope. That's going to hurt.
Here we go. Count them up.
4 count. We're getting up here.
5. Halfway there.
6. Elspeth, not without controversy. In the past, accused of stealing magic.
Back up at 8 once again.
From the
school
of
Looking for the 9 and the 10. Elspeth powering up here.
I think Elspeth just went Super Saiyan 2.
Right.
Here, 7.
Everyone in the crowd can give Elspeth their energy.
That's exactly right. Right now would be the time. Go ahead and throw a 1 in chat to give Elspeth your energy. 7, 8. We got a 1. There's a 9 count.
10,
there's
that is
a
it.
10 count.
Elspeth wins. Oh. Last was getting taken out of the door.
Amazing.
Saving the multiverse once again.
Saving the multiverse.
And becoming the C3W Women's Champion.
Incredible stuff.
Now let's watch the champ celebrate. As we kind of wrap things off here,
yes.
I want to once again thank CR for joining me in the booth here.
Of course, anytime, CR.
And we, of course, want to thank everyone for tuning in. We love doing the C3W stream, and
we
wouldn't be here tonight if it wasn't for the one from the Dreamhack to bring us out here. If you're a Dreamhack, check us out. We'll be hanging around. We got cool cards that we signed. We got a bunch of stickers. Go ahead and find us. No cowboy hats tomorrow. It's a little harder to find. But,
yeah, exactly right. We'll see. I like mine. They
very
are
hot.
Very, very warm.
Very warm.
Very warm.
But we'll for sure, we had a plan is I think tomorrow we'll be chilling out in the main con. And
I think that's right.
And then Sunday we'll be back up in the Magic Area over in the Omni.
That's exactly
but
right.
Stop us, get some stickers. And have some fun.
Absolutely right.
All right.
Yeah, thank you huge to all our patrons as well, who you saw at the beginning of the stream.
Right.
Patreon.com/CWG.
And with that, we'll talk to you all next time. Bye.